face that this world has forgotten.
What is up, you guys? And of course, welcome back to another Wi-Fi battle with just really the Scarinder. And today we're going up against Hannah. And well, quite frankly here, I am using somewhat of a niche team, but my opponent did so too. So for what it's worth, this was actually quite an exciting game. First and foremost, I decided to do a vote on the channel or Twitter to predetermine which Pokemon is going to have a heavy focus. BHM was the one that won that. We're using a Specs BHM, a slower variant, basically to be able to capitalize on analytics. BHM is only one thing that works against it, that it actually don't have Focus Blast, which is tremendously important for being psychic type. That said, it has its merits. And yeah, besides that, we have a Victor Bell here with Strength Sap and Black Sludge, defensive variant. A C. John Stoutland with Scrappy and Last Resort. Golurk with the Chapelberry and Stealth Rocks. Fairy Seal Valley, standard stuff. And a leftovers Poliwrath, especially based with Vacuum Wave. So yeah, pretty darn standard, I guess, to an extent there, but BHM is the main focus here. And we're facing off against a team that is, like I said, quite niche. We have a Stickweb variant of the Lebanese lower form. We have a Seal Valley, which is a fighting variant, Lantern, Murkrow, Mysterious, and Clefairy. So yeah, a lot of bulky with the Vileyes and whatnot. And this could, depending on my matchup, be a longer game, because while I am offensive, I'm not offensive enough to kind of deal with the Vileye Pokemon in that extent. So it's going to be interesting, and even more so to see what Murkrow is all about. So with that said, let's go into the match. So from the get-go here, I actually decided Victor Bell made the most sense, since it actually had a fair matchup. And she's in Swordloon, which I only can assume its real name is. I actually can't remember. So go for standard Stickweb, and I am expecting this to be fairly chunky, as I go for a Sludge Bomb, I bring it down to 1 HP, and Focus Sash gonna kick in. So I was really surprised by that. A Sludge Bomb would do roughly around 50% anyway. So it would have been a decided KO, but this definitely was a different strat, as it was not only that, it was outspeeding me, which he definitely usually doesn't do. So we get that away, but Stickweb is on the field, as here comes Murkrow. And I have no reason for staying in here. I'm not a big fan of Murkrow to that extent, so I'm gonna send in Garuga and go for a Defog. Now I was expecting something like Parish Song, Miluk, but she goes directly for a Brave Bird, and this Brave Bird does a good chunk. This is offensive Murkrow, and I can't risk anything versus this, though I do go for this Defog in case you want to sack play and go for another Brave Bird as Clefairy comes in. Versus Clefairy, Fairy versus Fairy, Clefairy win this matchup. Depending on this set, there's really nothing I can do, so I go for a Potting Shot, mainly just to get some niche momentum, I should say, over it, as I don't switch into this Pokemon, like I said, there that well, so I'm gonna go into Victor Bell just to get some HP, as she has the Yellow Magic, Thunder Wave, and yeah, that was unfortunate. Like I said, I was kind of predicting Stealth Rocks, but they do come through eventually here, as I am fully paralyzed. Unfortunately, I did go for Sludge Bomb there, as I miss a bit of a, you know, chunk momentum, I guess, to an extent here. So here goes Mr. Drevious, and I'm still fully paralyzed. So Yellow Magic is Yellow Magic, and I need to switch out, and I'm gonna bring my Poliwrath, expecting potentially Hex or Will-O-Wisp. But she goes for Hex, kind of like the standard set for Mistress is Will-O-Wisp, Hex, Pain Split, and Destiny Bond or Taunt. All of those axes are really, really, really annoying, but we don't get to follow up any of them. So she brings in Luna, I go for the Easy Scald, and well, I think we get the burn here, which is great. It's like Clefairy. Clefairy has Magic Guard, and yeah, it's just not a pretty sight. And I'll lose this matchup. I absolutely lose it. So I need to switch out. I'm going to switch in Optimus, trying to get my own rocks on the field, actually, as she switches out, goes to Mistress. And, well, what else can I do but actually stay in? Now, I did have a play of actually going back to Poliwrath, but the series of plays would just been the same. Actually, I went for Shadow Punch. That was unnecessary. And she'll just KO with me with Hex. So I wouldn't say it's a misprediction or anything like that, but I probably had a stronger place in mind. I just didn't want to risk them. As I'm gonna bring in Dekrik here, as I can easily take a Hex and KO this in return with a Psychic. But she goes for Taunt, thinking that I was gonna Nancy plot a trick room or whatnot, but no, I'm not going to. I'm gonna just pop it, and that's how you kill a mischievous. It's you violate, I barely notice it. So in goes Lumina, which is of course a lantern, and I really don't think they play here. Lantern is tough, so I'm gonna bring in Victory Bell, hoping she doesn't carry the likes of Ice Beam or predict that. As she goes for Scald, my Figgy kind of comes in, and here's where I realize that being a plus special attack is probably not that good against me, because I do get confused due to it with the Figgy Berry, which I forgot you could. So I'm not going to risk anything there. I'm switching Garuga. She goes for full switch. I am in theory in a range where Silvella is unnecessary, or it doesn't have any switch-ins left besides actually getting rid of stealth rocks and whatnot, but I have no reason to. I have no Pokemon here that's weak to rocks, hence hazard is not an issue unless it is stick away, but clearly. So bringing back Victor Bell, Victor Bell's do check Clefable. Clefable can't do anything besides potentially flamethrower, but even at that, I am a special defensive Victor Bell, and there is really nothing for me here to lose, as her only attack move here seems to be Moonblast. Which is alright, I do get my third fully paralyzation here, so Victor Bell is absolutely crippled as she keeps going for Moonblast, which doesn't do anything, and I'm going for Strength Sap, basically to kind of showcase to her that I can recover HP with my way. Unfortunately, the fair base isn't necessarily that, I was going to say bulky, but it really isn't, so I'm going to switch in Dendrick. Basically, my initial thought here was to take a hit, hoping that I don't get a lower special attack and go for a psychic. Murkrow is a thing here, but I don't believe she's gonna risk it. She goes to Lumina, which is great for us as we pull out the psychic, the analytic boosted psychic that is just numbing on the lantern, as I'll just finish it up with another psychic. Oh, I should say that I'm a speedier BGM. Which capitalize on boosting when it forces switches. Now here comes Murkrow. I don't switch into Murkrow. So I'm gonna sack play Garuga. I do believe BGM has some merits left in it, as like I said, I did eventually want to showcase what that was all about. So I have a reason to think that Murkrow could potentially be scoffed or banded, locked into something at least. So I'm gonna bring in the Fulf and do what Fulf does best, and that is actually go for the Sea John. Probably play this card a little bit too early, consider the circumstance, but yeah, she's burned, so I can't get her to sleep. Luckily for me, I do boost my speed anyway, which should put me in range where I should be able to actually wrap up the game. So I go for Last Resort, and what do you know, that's almost popping the Clefairy. Very luckily for me, my opponent here, Hannah, does not go for the yellow magic. That could have been crucial and disgusting in so many ways, but yeah, we get that out of the way. Here comes the Murkrow, and what do you know, it's a sea Murkrow with of course Prankster. So I was thinking, what move could this possibly do? Well, it does mirror move, sea mirror move after boosting its attack by 2, and I'm not taking this. I'm absolutely not taking this. This Breakneck Blitz is gonna pop me, and it popped me hard. I was so shocked by this, and impressed also, of course, as now I'm just gonna go for residual damage actually, just to try to get this thing dead. And I mean, the recall here absolutely is killing me dead, and my only play here now is vacuum waving with Poliwrath, hoping it is enough to wrap up the game. And what do you know, the car has the power, it's just not the right one, as if we just live on a Snitterhill, it will retaliate. Braver is gonna knock me out, and the last matchup is the Silvally fighting against the BGM. So the question is, does her Silvally have, you know, the move, something to damage me? But usually these Pokemon are carrying Crunch or U-Turn, and BGM is known for its bulk, as it will just, of course, die to this U-Turn. So this is, of course, a 1-0 victory in Hannah's favor, and for what it's worth, I was quite impressed. So yeah, I guess I should kind of wrap up what my initial thought about the game itself. Well, you know, Wi-Fi battles, you don't necessarily strive for winning. I do reconcile that. Had I not sacked Victor Bell, I would have won this game. Yeah, it's one of those things, like, I could have, I should have thought about Silver Valley a lot longer than I did. I was so convinced about BHM. You know, let's have that showcase. But alas, it wasn't meant to be. And I think I got to showcase at least a few niche things. And Hannah absolutely got to show hers. That C-Mirror Move Murkrow, I mean, what can I say? It's, I never in my life predicted it, and quite frankly, just because it worked, it just turned out to be this immense, awesome thing that, you know, you can't be mad about it, you're just genuinely impressed. So, for what it's worth, I'll take this loss. I think the better Nish won this matchup, and she absolutely deserved this victory. And of course, with that said, I really hope you guys enjoyed this battle. Don't sleep on Murkrow, ever. Have a great day, guys. Take care. Bye.